Well, Peru's interim president, Manuel Merino, has resigned after deadly protests and a mass resignation from his cabinet. He took on the role only 5 days ago after the former president, Martin Vizcarra, was removed over bribery allegations, which he denies. Tens of thousands of people have been protesting since Vizcarra stepped down. Well, our correspondent Mariana Sanchez now joins me from the capital, Lima. Mariana, Merino's gone after not even 1 week in power. It does seem like he faced a bit of a mutiny in government.
Well, I think it's a mutiny, Anastasia, that is based on the fact that there's been a lot of pressure from the nearly 1 week of millions of Peruvians in the streets of the country. Merino has resigned just about over an hour ago, and he said that he had accepted the challenge of bringing the country through these very harsh and difficult political times. He called himself a Democrat, and he did not, of course, say that his party, the Popular Action Party, was one of the main parties that pushed for the impeachment of former President Martin Vizcarra and put the country through these very difficult times. Now, Merino has resigned, and now that there's a group of congressmen who will have to decide who the next president is. There's been some celebration in the streets of Lima and the streets of the capital and in other parts of the country, people in bicycles, people using black clothes to commemorate and to honor the two students that were killed last night. This is what really triggered the resignations of one minister after another, including while the cabinet chief was being interviewed by a local radio, and the interviewer was telling the cabinet chief, the prime minister, that if he knew that so-and-so minister had resigned, and he said, I didn't know, I don't know. That's the only thing he answered. And then he was asked if he had had any conversations with interim president Merino then. And he said, well, that he had sent him a WhatsApp and that Merino had not answered. He wasn't answering calls. This is the level of disconnect with members of this less than a week government. And of course, a disconnect of what has been happening in the streets of the country, of thousands and thousands of protesters demanding that this government leave because they feel that it was a coup d'etat and not a democratically elected government. Nastasia.
And Mariana, we've been watching those live pictures there from Peru of people celebrating in the streets. Mariana Sanchez there for us in the capital of Peru. Thanks so much, Mariana.